above has helped me reclaim my story by giving me a platform to do that, by encouraging me to, you know, kind of, with a cancer diagnosis and with treatment, you finish treatment, and oftentimes people think that that's the end of your journey. And iRise Above definitely draws attention to the fact that that's not the end, that you have a new reality, and iRise Above has been there to support that reality and to acknowledge it and to give me some tools to reclaim power over that narrative and to begin to write my own story rather than following, you know, a prescribed story for the rest of my life. iRise Above empowers me to really author the story myself from a place of strength and of being who I am, and really, you know, authenticates my voice and validates my experiences. Since joining the iRise Above program, I have been reminded that I am alive and that I am healthy and I am strong and I am capable of taking on whatever it is that I envision I can take on. Be that confronting difficult feelings, difficult patterns that I may have fallen into as a result of the trauma from diagnosis and surgery and treatment. iRise Above recognizes me as an alive being with strength and power. I also really appreciate the fact iRise Above tends to look away from me as merely a survivor and shows me that not only am I surviving with breast cancer, but I'm thriving and I'm living. And I don't just need to live as if I'm hanging on to each day by a thread. I can make each day whatever it is I want it to be because I'm capable and strong and alive. If I were to give a piece of advice to a newly diagnosed young woman, I would encourage her to confront fear, and to confront fear knowing that love conquers all, and if you can love yourself, you can meet fear with strength. You can invest in yourself. You can become physically strong again. You can become spiritually strong again. You can be brought back to who you were, and maybe you'll even be a better, stronger, more loving person, a more loving version of yourself. I would encourage them to not submit to fear. I think fear is the thing that can paralyze you, and when you're paralyzed, you might not be invested in your spiritual strength or physical strength. I think the challenge is to stay invested in your physical well-being, in your emotional well-being, in your spiritual well-being, and to stay grounded in those things so that you're unshakable by fear. What makes me rise are my nieces and nephews. To see them come into this world and watch them grow has been the greatest gift of my life. And I really feel like they deserve my love, and they deserve to have my love in person as long as they possibly can, and my support, because I believe that they are the future and they are the most beautiful beings I've ever met. And I want to encourage them to hang on to the innocence that makes them so beautiful and pure. I want them to learn by my example. I want them to not be afraid. I want them to be strong and courageous. And I feel as though it's my duty to show them that in my life, I've been strong, I've been courageous, and you can do it too. And I hope that by my example, they will live their lives that way.